Dr. Anton Dvorak, in a visit to America, was influenced by the American sound. The band forms in concert to proudly present the finale from Dvorak's New World Symphony. We proudly present the 1974 enshrinees to the Hall of Fame. Our first enshrinee played a position that was called halfback during his playing years of 1941 to 52. He rushed for 4,197 yards on 1,025 carries. caught 69 passes for 579 yards, scored 31 touchdowns, completed 105 passes for 1,642 yards and 16 touchdowns, punted 45 times, intercepted 9 passes, returned 45 punts, and ran back 71 kickoffs. Considered one of the most versatile players in pro football history, ladies and gentlemen, escorted by Nancy Diefenbacher, former Green Bay Packer, Tony Cannadale. As Tony leaves center field, we call your attention to the 50-yard line on the south side of the field, where Hall of Fame Queen Patty Carpenter, Mayor Stanley Kamik, and Earl Shriver, President of the Hall of Fame Board of Trustees, will greet our enshrinees. Our next enshrinee was called the first great middle linebacker by Chicago Bear coach Abe Gibran. He starred in the NFL for 15 years, and his performances have never been forgotten. He is the 14th Chicago Bear to be enshrined in the Hall of Fame. He played with the Bears 14 years. No other Bear played so long, and very few played as well. Ladies and gentlemen, escorted by Susan Feske, enshrinee Bill George. Offensive tackles in pro football. In his 21-year career with the Cleveland Browns, he tallied 1,608 points by kicking 810 extra points and 264 field goals. At the time of his retirement, he held 10 NFL and 24 Cleveland Browns records. Ladies and gentlemen, escorted by Gail George, enshrinee Lou the Toe Rosa. NFL, our next enshrinee, blessed with outstanding speed, exceptional agility and reflex action, and a fierce determination to win, really set the league on fire in his rookie season. He intercepted 14 passes in a 12-game schedule, a record that still stands. Vince Lombardi once instructed Bart Starr, "Don't throw anywhere near him. He's the best there is." Upon his retirement in 1965, he had earned almost universal acclaim as the finest cornerback ever to play the game. Ladies and gentlemen, escorted by Darlene Harper, enshrinee Dick Cueball Night Train Lane. Yeah. For those of you who were not privileged to attend the enshrinee dinner last night, we might tell you that Train's old high school coach and his presenter today informed all of the crowd that he had another name back in those days instead of Night Train, and that was Cueball. And I expect that will live with him forever. Thank you.
can't have no more fun.
They're gone, honey. They're right there. They're in those trucks.
Great football players. This was indeed an honor and a privilege.